Hey everyone and welcome back to another mining chamber video. In today's video we are going to be using more than one GPU to mine on our main PC. So you can use this when you're trying to game and mine at the same time. You can have one GPU mining full time and then the other one is off for whatever else you want to use it for. We will also go over some BIOS options that you might have to change and everything you need to know about drivers and setup within your main PC. So now let's go ahead and get into the video right after the intro. Now before we start this video, let's first talk about part 1 which I've released before this video, and in part 1 we talked about how to effectively mine with your main PC, and then we went over certain settings that you want to change in your Windows setup as well as a couple of things that you need to keep in mind when you're mining, and then we went over two different mining software as well as a mining operating system. So now we're not going to be getting into details with these in this video, so just letting you guys know if you want any clarification you can go to that video. So if you haven't watched part 1 yet, I would highly suggest going to part 1 first and then coming and finishing part 2. So now let's get to it. In this video I'm going to be using an RX 580 beside of my main GPU on my PC, which is an RX 5700. So it will be two AMD GPUs connected to the same PC. Now there are a couple of configurations that you might have differently, which you might have an AMD card, an Nvidia card, or two Nvidia cards, or even more cards than just two. So it's all up to you. You can apply this same concept to more than two cards, but it might be different when it comes to Nvidia and AMD being mixed together. So I will be talking about that when we get to the section of installing your drivers. Now before we get to the drivers part, let's first talk about how you will be connecting more than one GPU to your motherboard. So there are multiple different ways that you can use here, and the most common way is just inserting your GPU within your case into a different slot. Now when it comes to slots on your motherboard, you want to rank them with the largest slots. So you first need to use your primary slots, which are the long ones, and you'll use those in order. So the first long slot is your primary slot, and then the second one will be the second biggest slot. So you won't need to use the small ones unless you finished your larger ones first. Now to connect the larger ones, you can simply plug into it your GPU and then just mount that GPU properly. Although if you do end up putting it inside of your PC itself and then you have your PC case covered, then just remember that the heat can be a problem if you try to enclose them in a case. So it's best if you try to open up your case or leave the side panel open, or just have an open frame case as well, which are pretty good. For example, for my main PC, I'm using a Thermaltake Core P3, which is an open frame case, and it's really nice. You can simply swap out any GPU you want and add any GPU you'd like. So now the method that I'm going to be using for connecting my GPU will be through a riser. So you can buy these risers on Amazon, or you can go to the stores that I have the links for on miningchamber.com. Some of them will have some risers on there, so you can just browse through them and find whichever one you want to buy from. Now these risers are basically an extension for your motherboard. So you can just plug in the 1x PCIe Express slot, and then from there you can leave your GPU wherever is safe. Now in this video I don't put my GPU in that much of a safe spot, but please make sure you put the GPU in a safe spot. When the fans spin you can see some movement on the GPU, so just make sure that you mount it somewhere safe and it doesn't fall over or break the fans. Now two things you want to keep in mind when it comes to connecting multiple GPUs is first that you want to get rid of your SLI and Crossfire, so you won't be using either SLI from Nvidia or Crossfire from AMD, because that will put your hash rate lower. And the second thing you want to keep in mind is your power. So you want to make sure that your power supply has enough power to supply whatever additional GPUs you're trying to power. And since you're most likely going to be also gaming or doing any other productive work on your PC, you want to make sure that you have a capable enough PSU to power all your GPUs. Now generally with two GPUs that don't consume too much power like we have here, the RX 5700 and the RX 580, you can go ahead and use a 750 watt, that's not a problem. But if you're trying to run a GPU like an RTX 3080 or a 3090 or a Radeon 7, then I highly suggest getting at least a 1000 watt power supply to stay on the safe side. Now when it comes to power supplies as well, you want to make sure you have enough cables to power the GPUs. So now in this case I have my Thermaltake RGB 750 watts, and I do have extra cables, so I was able to plug in another VGA cable to power up another GPU. Now when you power up your other GPU, you also want to power the riser that comes with it, and that riser takes 1/6 pin. And if you don't have enough cables to power your riser as well and your GPU, then you can try to use a Molex to power your riser, but it's not the safe option. I would highly suggest getting splitters, and those splitters will just give you an additional port to plug into it the riser. So if you have a cable that has 2x8 pins, you can go ahead and plug into it a splitter, and then from there you can power the riser and the 2 8 pins speeds on the GPU itself. You can also try to find splitters in the stores I mentioned on the website as well. Now there are also the Ribbon PCIe extensions that plug into the large ports, and these also transfer power, so you can use these as well and directly connect it to your GPU. All the links for everything will be in the descriptions below. And now that wraps it up for the physical part of this section. So now let's talk about the different configurations, AMD and NVIDIA. Now one thing that you need to do for either of the combinations of GPU is that you need to change a couple of BIOS settings. So the main settings that you want to make sure is enabled is mining mode or 4G decoding. So if you have 4G decoding or mining mode in your BIOS settings, then make sure that you set that as enabled. Usually it will be in the advanced tab, so just browse through your BIOS and try to find them. And if you don't find either of those settings and you have a really old motherboard, then you might not be able to run two GPUs, but you can still give it a try, so you don't need to stress it at all. And even if you have a newer motherboard and you don't have those settings, you can still continue throughout the video. You might not run into any issues at all. Now there are a couple of other settings that you can change if you do run into issues of your motherboard not detecting your GPU, and that is your PCIe link speeds. So you can just jump in on there and change them to Gen 2 and try that, and then you can also try Gen 3. So just mess around with those settings until it works for you. Now as for the different combinations of GPUs, if you do AMD and NVIDIA at the same time, it can be such a headache when you're running it in Windows 10, because Windows 10 just does not cope well with having multiple different GPU drivers on there. But again, you can still give it a try. My recommendations would be using the HiveOS method that we discussed in part 1. That will be much easier to run with both GPUs. You don't have to install any drivers, it's automatic right away. But if you're still insistent on using Windows 10, then the first thing you want to do is you want to make sure the primary GPU has its drivers installed, and then plug in your secondary GPU and install its drivers. So if your primary GPU is AMD and you have your drivers already, then you're set. Plug in your second GPU, install your NVIDIA drivers. You might experience a lot of crashes and a lot of blue screens, so just be careful on that end. And now as of having the same vendors for the GPUs, such as AMD and AMD or NVIDIA and NVIDIA, you don't have to do anything extra. Just plug in your secondary GPU and run through it without any issues. But let's say if you have a 1060 on your main PC and you're plugging in an RTX 3000 series, then you're most likely going to need to install the latest drivers. You can also try to run it without installing the new drivers. It might also work without any issues after a restart. So give that a try and mess around with it until you get the drivers sorted out. If you end up running into driver issues, especially on the AMD side, you can try to use DDU to uninstall your drivers. Now, DDU is something very useful to use. It helps you uninstall your drivers, and it does it in a way that it cleans it fully off of the system. So to use DDU, all you need to do is boot into safe mode, and then once you boot into safe mode, you can go ahead and run DDU and proceed with uninstalling your drivers. And if you don't know how to boot into safe mode, you can easily look it up and they will give you the instructions for that. So now after I have the two GPUs plugged into the computer, the first thing you want to do is you want to go to your device manager. So once you go ahead and open up your device manager, go under your display adapters, and in there just make sure that both of the cards that you have plugged in are showing. So here I have the RX 5700 as well as the RX 580. Now that I confirmed that it's working on this side, I can go ahead and open up MSI Afterburner, and then here as well I can see if I click on this GPU icon right here, I can see that I have both of my GPUs showing here. So that means I can just overclock them individually. But now since we are on an AMD system, I will be using Wattman instead, which comes with the AMD drivers. So if I go to Wattman and go to performance and then tuning, you guys will see here you have two options for two GPUs. So the AMD RX 5700 is GPU number one, and then the 580 is GPU number two. So as usual, before you start mining, you want to first apply your overclocks. Now from part 1, I've already saved my overclocks into a profile for my 5700, so all I need to do is just go to here and do load profile and then load my mining profile. So if you guys did not catch that part, then please go to part 1 and then you'll find the information for that there. As for my second GPU, it's my first time plugging it into this computer, so I can't load the profile for it. So I'm going to apply the mining overclocks that you can find on miningchamber.com, and then after I apply those overclocks, I can go ahead and start mining. Alright, so now that my overclocks are applied for mining for both of the cards, I can go ahead and start mining. So now as we did in the first part, we've used Cryptex Miner and the Phoenix Miner. So in this part, we're also going to be using Cryptex and Phoenix. You guys can feel free to use any miner you like. There won't be any issue with that. So in Cryptex, it's very straightforward to turn off one GPU and turn on the other. All you have to do is just click on those green switches and then you can turn off the respective GPU. So now I'm just going to give it some time until they kick in, and then after they kick in, I will go ahead and turn off one of them. So now after CryptX kicked in, you guys can see here I'll be making almost $300 a month, and now it does show a little bit lower for my RX 5700, and that is due to me screen recording and displaying on two monitors, which is completely fine. So now in CryptX, if I want to turn off my primary GPU, I would just go ahead and hit this switch, and then now it will be off. So now it will just take some time to recalculate, and then after it finishes recalculating, the RX 580 will only be on, and then the 5700 will be off. So here you can see the RX 580 is the only one that's mining, and I'm going to be making almost $100 a month rather than almost $300 a month. The bright side of this is I can have this GPU mine 24/7 and I don't need to worry about it at all, and then I can just do whatever I want on the system. So now let's go ahead and turn off CryptX Miner and let me show you guys how to do this in Phoenix Miner. Now in Phoenix Miner, all you need to do is you can go ahead to the config file that we made previously, and then in the config file, you guys can make some changes here. So now continuing off where we left off from the part 1, here we have the overclock settings for the 5700, and now we have two GPUs. So to add your overclocks for the second GPU, all I need to do is just add a comma and then add the numbers for it. So for the core voltage as well, I can just do a comma 850, and then for the memory clock, I can do comma and 2150. So what that would do is apply these overclocks for each GPU respectively, and the first GPU will get the first number and the second GPU gets the second number, and it keeps going on. So for the fan speed, I can leave it at 60, which will apply to both cards. And now after I run this, it will apply my settings for both of the cards. But now since we're planning on mining with just one card, by adding this command right here, -GPUs2, we're only going to put overclocks for one of the cards. But if you're planning on mining with more cards, so for example, if I have a third card plugged in, I would say comma 3, and then I can go ahead and add the overclocks of the third card after the first one. And to find the right index number for your GPU, you can go ahead and try this. So first I'm going to comment out my overclock. So putting a hashtag behind oldest line means it will skip the line. And then I'm going to do that to the GPUs as well. And then I'm going to save the file. And now I am going to go ahead and run my Phoenix Miner as an administrator. So you guys can see here, I have GPU 1 is my RX 5700 and my GPU number 2 is the RX 580. So if I close the Phoenix Miner and then I go ahead and skip GPU 1 and just say I want to mine with GPU number 2, and then I can apply my overclocks here as well. After that, I can save my file and then I can run Phoenix Miner again. So after I run Phoenix Miner again, you guys can see here that it's only using the RX 580. So now if you go to your metrics in your AMD Wattman, you can see here that my GPU 1 is being used at 29%. It's jumping a little bit around because I'm recording the screen, but then you can see here GPU number 2 is at 100%. So the GPU number 2 is being used for mining and then GPU 1 is free to use. So what that means is you can go ahead and play any games you want and then you'll be set without any issues. You can shut down your monitor while it's mining, you can keep it up overnight, you can do whatever you like and you'll just be making money from your secondary GPU. So that will be it for the video, guys. I hope it was helpful and I hope you guys learned something new. Now if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below, and if you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit the thumbs up, and if you're new here, hit the subscribe button. We have a couple of GPU overview videos coming up very soon. So till then, I will catch you guys next time. I hope you have a wonderful day.